Generally, we have two types of Coombs tests. Coombs tests can be either direct or indirect. In direct Coombs test, we determine antibodies that are already binded to the surface of red blood cells. To explain this, here we have a normal blood sample, there are some red blood cells, and also there are some antibodies that are circulating in the bloodstream. And here we have a second blood sample. There are also some red blood cells, but the major difference is that some of the antibodies, due to the autoimmune reaction, are binded to red blood cells, which is quite dangerous because such red blood cells will be destroyed in the spleen. So to find out whether there are some antibodies attached to red blood cell surface, first of all, we have to remove all other particles. So initially, we wash collected blood sample in a saline, and by this we remove everything except red blood cells. Then we add to this mixture of red blood cells a reagent, which is antihuman globulin. Antihuman globulin binds to antibodies that are located on the surface of red blood cells. In the first case, nothing happens. But in the second case, when antihuman globulin binds to antibodies on red blood cells, such red blood cells aggregate and precipitate. And agglutination of red blood cells in the presence of antihuman globulin, we consider a positive Coombs test. So positive Coombs tests tell us about the presence of antibodies on red blood cells. If antibodies are not binded to red blood cells, then there will be no precipitation. Absence of agglutination tells us that there are no antibodies on red blood cells, and thereby no autoimmune reaction, which is completely normal. But if agglutination occurs, it tells us about the autoimmune reaction against red blood cells, which is definitely pathology. So we consider it as positive if agglutination occurs. Direct Coombs test we use in cases where we suspect autoimmune hemolytic anemia. It's patients with chronic lymphocytic leukemia, patients with lymphomas, and also patients with autoimmune disorders. In contrast to this, indirect Coombs test we use to detect antibodies that potentially in the future can bind to red blood cells and cause hemolysis. So if we take a blood sample, there are some red blood cells and antibodies. Then we remove red blood cells, so only antibodies remain. And then we add new red blood cells. And we are interested, will immune reaction occur or not? So in first scenario, antibodies do not recognize red blood cells as foreign agents. As a result, they do not bind to them. But in the second scenario, antibodies recognize red blood cells as foreign agents that are dangerous. As a result, they bind to their surface. In the next step, we add antihuman globulin. And antihuman globulin binds only to antibodies that are located on the surface of red blood cells. So in the first case, antihuman globulin won't interact with red blood cells and antibodies. But in the second case, because antibodies are located on the surface of red blood cells, antihuman globulin binds to antibodies, and as a result, agglutination of red blood cells occurs. With agglutination, they precipitate, and agglutination of red blood cells in the presence of antihuman globulin we consider as positive indirect Coombs test. So in the first case, antihuman globulin do not bind to red blood cells, simply because there are no antibodies against red blood cells. In the second case, because there are some antibodies against red blood cells, test is positive. So test is positive if agglutination occurs. And indirect Coombs test we use for prevention. For example, to prevent hemolytic disease of the newborn or to prevent complications in case of blood transfusion. So when we are talking about direct Coombs test, we are talking about the present. When we are talking about indirect Coombs test, we are talking about the future.